All right, let's see if we can extend our definition of subtraction to polynomials then. So here, when we do the subtraction, we borrow and unbundle stuff, and then we do the subtraction. But in polynomials, we just take this polynomial minus that whole polynomial. Then I'm going to go 6 minus 7, negative 1. So I cannot borrow so many x's to make so many units. Or I cannot borrow so many x squares to make 1x. And therefore, there is no unbundling process here or borrowing process. You just have to leave the numbers as is. Do you think that will work here by not borrowing? Let's see. Okay, so that was our polynomial. What if I just do the same thing here? Then what? Doesn't that look very much like that? But how can we read that number? Since it's not digits anymore, we have negatives involved. So if you write it in the expanded form, you'll see how it's okay to have that. So we'll have 4 in this spot, negative 7 in that spot. If we write it in the expanded notation, we have negative 1 is in the units place, which is right there. 4 is in the tens place, negative 1 in the hundreds place, negative 7 in the 1,000 place, and 4 in the 10,000 place. And then if we perform our addition and subtraction, you'll get the same 32,939 that we got before. So we don't have to unbundle, but if you unbundle, the number that is here is your answer. So if you make sure that all these digits are positive, then we can read off the decimal number. Otherwise, you have to do this process. But we wanted to show you how they really are parallel structures between decimal numbers and polynomials. Let's do some practice questions here and see what you can do. Pause the video here and then we'll discuss it. So just like you did addition, a plus b is my unit, so I'm going to go 3 minus the u minus the v, that many a plus b's. So again, a plus b was my unit. Again, like units, so centimeters and centimeter squares together. Okay? All right, do that on your own. All right, so let's do some work here. 3 kilometers is going to be 3,000 meters. 200 centimeters is going to be 2 meters. And then we have everything in meters, so now we can perform the subtraction, giving us 3,000 minus 9, which is 2,991 meters. Last one. 6.3 meters can be thought of as 6 meters plus 0.3 meters. 6 meters is 600 centimeters, 0.3 meters is 30 centimeters. So go ahead and do that subtraction. If you're not sure how we got that, this is 0.0, so you could borrow one and so on and finish it off. All right, let's do subtraction of fractions now. Just like we were doing addition, if we overlap, then they'll be same units. And then we'll be able to do them. So that involved doing what? This. So now I want to take away these pieces from here. So how many pieces are those? That's 5. And I have 6 here. So I'm going to take away 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take away 5. So how much of the yellow original is left? That's 1 out of 15. So making equivalent fractions so that we can compare them, otherwise we cannot add or subtract. Then we can perform just like whole number subtraction. All right, do these problems on your own, and then we'll discuss the answers. So make, again, common denominator. That way we have equivalent fractions, and then we can subtract. Okay? So it's exactly like addition, the only difference being what? making sure that you have common denominator if you're working with fractions. So when you're doing mixed fractions, again, we can take care of the whole number parts. So 5 minus the 2 gives me 3 wholes, but now I want 3 quarters minus 2 thirds. So 3 quarters minus 2 thirds, I'm going to have to make common denominator. And now I have 9 twelfths minus 8 twelfths, which will give me 1 twelfth. So I'm left with 3 and a twelfth. These already have the common denominator, but look at this minus sign. The unit here is 1 over x plus 4. Now we want to perform this subtraction. Remember, like terms are subtracted together. So we're going to have 2 minus the negative 2 and x minus the 5x. 2 minus minus 2. Minus minus means take additive inverse of negative 2, which is 2. So that's a plus 2. So that'll give me 4. X minus 5x will give me negative 4x. And so that will be my final answer. Subtracting complex numbers, we already saw. Take real parts and imaginary parts and do the subtraction and get the answer. Remember, I was square root negative 1. So now let's extend our definition to radicals. Let's see if you can do that on your own. Again, like terms. So here's my like terms. Here's my like terms. So 3 minus 4, square root 2s, and negative 5 minus 6, cube root 3s. So that'll give me that answer. 3 minus 4, negative 1. So negative 1, square root 2s, and negative 11, cube root 3s. So square root 2 and cube root 3 served as units in the previous example here. All right, try this on your own. Pause the video and then check. So we're circling the same units, so it will help you solve it. Go ahead, finish it off. All right, very good. Okay. All right, here are more practice questions. Subtract the following then. All right, go ahead. Pause the video, because then you can check whether you have it or not. So the first thing we've done is take additive inverse of all of that. Additive inverse of negative 4 square root 2 would be positive 4 square root 2. Additive inverse of negative 6 cube root 3 will be positive 6 cube root 3. Now it's just adding like terms, right? Negative 3 plus 4 is going to give me 1 square root 2. Negative 5 plus 6 is going to be positive 1 cube root 3. All right, let's do this next one on your own. So whenever you see negative of anything, that's additive inverse of that, and then you can do the addition or subtraction as necessary. All right, check if you got the last one correct. Okay, so whenever you are subtracting a quantity, you can think of it as multiplying, like there's an imaginary negative 1 here, so you're multiplying negative 1 all the way across using distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. Or you can think of it as additive inverse of that quantity and then add like terms. All right, more examples. Go ahead. So 3 of those minus 5 of those, x plus 1 is our unit. So that'll make it negative 2x plus 1s. See if you're understanding all that. Make sure you're understanding each of these examples. Otherwise, make sure that you are getting some help from somebody to understand. Let's just go over them. Again, like terms here is x plus 1 is a like term. 3 minus 5 is negative 2. Here we have negative 3 minus a of x plus 1s. Nothing we can do about them. Negative 3 minus 7, which will give me negative 10. Same thing here, except the unit is square root 2x plus 1. And here we have x is our unit, and 3 square root 2 minus 5. And you can't really do anything about that. All right, what do you think will be the function f minus g of x and r minus s of t and so on? So again, you have those two functions and you're subtracting. Now it's just an exercise in subtraction. Same thing here. Can you see why that's the answer? T squared minus 5t squared will give me negative 4t squared. Positive 3t minus a 4t will give me a negative t. And a minus a positive 12 will give me a minus 12. Here, first we have to compute f of a and h of a, and then do the subtraction, which will give me 2a minus 4a will give me negative 2a. The plus 4 will stay, minus square root a will be here. Okay? So this is how you compute subtraction of functions. See what you can do.